हेलो एवरीवन, गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी टेक एंड डिस्कस अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट चैप्टर ऑफ योर सिलेबस विच इज प्रोबेबिलिटी. डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी टेक एंड डिस्कस सम इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चंस रिलेटेड टू प्रोबेबिलिटी एंड सॉल्विंग देम. नाउ इन टुडे क्लास वी ऑल्सो टेक एंड सॉल्व सम इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चंस based on probability. Okay, now we take a very important question of your NCERT exercise. Let's see. Your question is a bag contains three red balls and five black balls. A ball is drawn at random from the bag. From the bag. What is the probability that? Find the probability that the ball drawn is. First, red. Second one was black. Now let's see its solution. Yes, this is a very important question of your NCERT book based on probability. Let's see the question. Here, a bag contains 3 red balls and 5 black balls. Okay, now let's see. A bag contains 3 red and 5 black balls. So, total number of balls is what? Let's see. Total number of balls in the bag is what? 3 plus 5, this is 8 balls. Okay, so total number of our elementary event is what? 8 na? Because of this bag contains how many total balls? 8 balls. So that is total number of elementary event. So dear friend, total number of elementary event is what? 8. Okay, because of a ball is drawn at random out of 8 balls na? Because 8 balls contains 3 red and 5 black balls. So total number of balls in that bag, particular bag, is what? 8. So total number of elementary event, or you can say that total number of sample space is what? 8. Okay, this is the total number of sample space, which is what? 8. Okay, dear students, now look. Now, dear students, this bag, we find the probability that a ball is drawn at random, and we find the probability that the ball drawn is red or blue. Red or blue. So let's see. So now we've taken some of the first part. So we find the probability of getting a red ball now. So number of red balls. How many red balls are there? This is 3. So dear friend, this is the favorable outcomes. So number of favorable outcomes associated to event E, that is number of
favorable outcome, that is NE, is what? 3.
Thus,
what I do? Thus, probability of getting a red ball, a red ball, the probability of getting a red ball is what? Number of favorable outcomes upon total number of all possible outcomes.
This is the common formula, this is the general formula. And dear student, in your chapter there are only one formula and all the questions of that chapter based on this formula. Okay,
so now NE is 3 upon 8. This is the required solution of the given question.
So in this way, the probability of getting a red ball is what? 3/8. Okay, now similarly we take and solve the second part of this question. Let's see.
The second part of this question is what? We find the probability that the ball is the drawn ball is red. So this number of black balls in the bag is what? This is 5.
Number of black balls is what? 5.
That is number of trial of happening, the drawn ball is black is what? Number of favorable outcome, that is number of outcome, that is N is equal to 5.
This is the number of favorable outcome, means this is the trial in which the drawn ball is what? Black. Okay, thus
probability of getting the black ball, is what? Number of favorable outcomes upon total number of all possible outcomes is equal to 5/8.
This is the required solution of the given question. It means that the ball drawn is what? Black. Okay. So in this way, dear student, you can solve each and every questions of your NCERT exercise based on this topic. Okay, based on probability. Now, dear students, we take and solve some important question of your NCERT exercise based on probability. Let's see.
Let's see.
And your question is, 12 defective pens are accidentally mixed with
132
good ones.
Okay.
It is one pen is taken out at random.
One pen is taken out of random.
Okay, one pen is taken out of random, one random from this lot,
from this lot.
Okay, find the probability that
find the probability that
The pen taken out is good one.
The pen taken out is good one.
Yes, so this is also a very important question of your NCERT exercise. Okay, now let's see your solution. So, dear friend, in that question, look. Look,
here there are 20 defective pens are there,
and 12 defective pens are there, and accidentally mixed with 132 good ones. It means that ki total number of pens in this lot is what 132 plus 12, because of 12 defective pens is already accidentally mixed with 132 good ones. So total number of all elementary event is what? 132 plus 12, because of this lot contains total number of pens is what? 132 good ones and 12 defective pens are there. So first of all, we write the total number of pens in this lot is what? 12 plus 132. 12 plus 132.
That is 144. So total number of pens in this lot is 144. And that is total number of all elementary event. Total number of all elementary event is what? That is total number of sample space is what? 144. Okay, total number of elementary event is what?
144. Now, dear friend, in this lot, one pen is drawn at random. It means that, and taken out of random from this lot, find the probability that the pen taken out is good one. So, how many pens in this lot is good ones?
So total number of good pen is what
132 na, and 12
is defective, 12s are defective. So total number of here in this lot total number of good pens is what? 132. That is
number of favorable outcomes.
That is number of favorable outcomes. That is NE. Number of trial signature event is happens is what? 132.
Okay, dear students. Thus,
probability of getting a good one is what? Number of favorable outcomes upon all possible outcomes.
Number of favorable outcomes and all possible outcomes.
That is what, dear friend, n is what? 132 upon 144.
Now look, we split it by, now look, what now?
12 ones are 144. That is
11 upon 12 is the right answer. Okay, dear friend. So in this way, dear friend, we solve this question of your NCERT exercise. This is one of the most important question. So please, dear friend, do more and more practices of that type of questions. After that, you can solve each and every question of your NCERT exercise based on probability. Okay, this is clear, everyone? Okay. Now, dear friends, we take and solve some other important questions based on probability. Let's see. Now we take a very important question of your syllabus, and your question is: a box contains.
This question comes in previous board examination. Okay, so please clear the concept of this question. A box contains
20 cards numbered from
20 cards. 20 cards numbered from
1 to 20.
Numbered
from 1 to 20. Okay, now a card is drawn at random.
A card is drawn at random.
A card is drawn at random. Okay. From the box.
From the
box.
A card is drawn at random from the
box. Okay. Find the probability that.
Find the probability that.
Find the probability that the number on the drawn card is
the number on the drawn card is
first divisible by 2 or 3.
Divisible by 2 or 3. And
second one, a prime number.
A prime number. Now let's see its solution.
Okay. This is also a very important question. Means this box. Contains how many
cards? 20 cards. Since this box contains 20 cards numbered from 1 to 20.
Numbered from 1 to 20. That is
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19 and 20.
Numbered as 1 to 20. Okay. Now, all possible outcomes is what? Total number of elementary event is 20. It is clear that
here. The total number of elementary event is what? Means total number of sample space is 20. It is clear.
Now we take and solve the first part of this question. Dear sir, the favorable conditions related to that event. Suppose let E be the event that here. One card is drawn at random. Okay, choosing. Let us take the E be the event that drawn card is
divisible by 2 or 3.
Divisible by 2 or 3.
Good. So, how many numbers which are divisible by 2 or 3? How many numbers are there?
So, total number of possible outcomes is what? 20, na?
Now look, this, and this one. So how many cards which are divisible by 2 or 3? So 2 is also divisible by 2.
So 1 card from 1 to 20, na? फिर क्वेश्चन है अबाउट 20 नंबर एज वन डिविजिबल बाई टू और थ्री. ओके
तो लुक हाउ मेनी डिजिट्स आर देयर विच आर डिविजिबल बाई टू और थ्री. तो टोटल नंबर ऑफ डिजिट्स विच आर डिविजिबल बाई टू और थ्री इज व्हाट. लेट्स सी, टू थ्री फोर. ओके सिक्स, सिक्स इज ऑल्सो डिविजिबल बाई टू. As well as if we take 2 or 3, so only 6 and 18 and okay, now look 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 and 13. So total number of cards which are divisible by 2 or 3
is what?
20. Okay. So in this way, divisible by 2. So thus, total number of cards which are divisible by 2 or 3 is how many cards are there? Look, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 and 13.
Okay.
Okay. So 13. This is favorable condition to that cards is divisible by 2 or 3. Thus, probability of getting a card divisible by 2 or 3 is what? Number of favorable outcomes upon all possible outcomes is what? 13 upon 20. This is the required solution of the given question. Okay? This is the required solution of the given question. Okay, so in this way you can solve that type of. Now similarly we take and solve the second part of this question. We draw a card. A card is drawn at random from the pile. Then we find the probability of getting that card a prime number. Okay. Now look. So how prime numbers were which have only two factors. So number of favorable. So total number of cards on of prime number. Here total number of cards of prime number is what?
A prime number, you know that very well, which contains only two factors, one and itself.
Okay, so total number of cards of prime number is what? Look, 2, okay, 3 is also prime, 5 is also prime, 7 is also prime, 11 is also prime, 13 is also prime, 17 is also prime and 19 is also prime. So how many cards of prime numbers? Look, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
So 8 cards of prime numbers are there. Okay,
thus probability of getting the card of a prime number is what? Number of favorable outcomes upon all possible outcomes, that is 8 upon 20, 4 to the 4, 5 the means 2 upon 5. This is the required solution. Okay?
So, dear student, this is the method to solve that type of question. So, please, dear student, do more and more practices of that type of questions. After that, you can solve each and every questions of your NCERT exercise based on these questions. Okay? So, in this way, clear the concept of that question. Now we take and solve some other important questions based on these topics. Let's see. Now look, the question is, a bag contains 5 white and 7 red balls.
5 white and 7 red balls.
Okay, 7 red balls. One ball is drawn at random.
One ball is drawn at random.
One ball is drawn at random. What is the probability that
What is the
probability that ball drawn is white?
Now let's see its solution.
Dear sir, it is clear. We already solved the question based on these topics. Let's see. So a bag contains 5 white and 7 red balls. So total number of balls in contains the bag is what? 5 plus 7. That is 12 balls. So all possible outcomes is what? 12, na?
So here total number of balls in the bag is what? 5 plus 7, that is 12 balls. Okay, thus that is total elementary event or say the total number of sample space is what? 12
for that question. Okay,
now here we find the probability of the ball is drawn is white.
So favorable conditions what? How many white balls are there?
So total number of white balls is what? 5. That is number of favorable outcomes is what? Number of event that the ball
is white
is what? 5. Okay, thus that is probability of getting white ball is what? Number of favorable outcomes and all possible outcomes, that is 5 upon 12. This is the required solution of the question. Thus
clear the concept of this question. So dear students, in this way you can solve all the question of your NCERT exercise based on these topics. Okay, Thus, dear students, in this way, in today's class, we take and discuss some important questions based on the probability. So please do more and more practices of all the questions we discuss in that class and also in previous classes. Now in next class, we take and solve some other important questions of your syllabus. Okay, now thanks to all.